Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Heartly affection and love to my Divine Holy Master, Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu, Shishman Bhakti Pragyan Kesho Goswami, and to my Sikhya Guru, Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Pad Shishman Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. I've told you before that Swamiji Maharaj has brought me. He cut the jungle and made a very beautiful platform and sent me. When I came first Holland 1 month before, I have not dreamt or thought that so many good devotees will meet me, so good kirtan will be done, all will dance, and so big preaching will be done here. But magically, all was done. All these senior devotees met me and for 2 weeks about we are preaching my soul. Go here. I was overjoyed to see all these things. I have never dreamt that I will come to Western countries. I have preaching like this will be going on. When I was going to England, I was so much feeling separation for you all. In the way I was all were coming in my mind and heart, how they are dancing, their dancing, how they were singing, how they patiently they were hearing all these words. I thought that it may be that again Swami Asi Bhaktivedanta Swami has come again. And with so such a
enthusiasm.
All right. And in the same way, I was thinking that I am going to England, but I don't know anyone. So what will be there? But I saw that a gathering of 100 persons were in airport, were dancing and there's so many garlands and everything. And they are shouting, Hare Krishna, Jai Guru Dev ki Jai, Swamiji ke Prabhupada. I was thinking that here with so many good playing on mridanga and harmonium, what name?
Suparna
and all are not there. Who will do kirtan? I saw that so many best singers like what name?
Gyanadas.
So good players of mridanga joined me and everywhere.
And mridanga wala?
Mridanga wala, so good.
Madhusudan. Marsha, you all know?
2, 2, 3, 3 mridanga. After finishing our London, we went to
Bath.
Very big procession.
With Budhara, you know Budhara?
You know, Budhara, but Bhudhara Prabhu.
Budhara.
Those who practice earth only. Goat preaching was there. After that, went to
Glastonbury.
Glastonbury, yes. You are.
About 500, more than 500,
yeah.
hall was. And all that fancy we are hearing, so more than 500 devotees were there.
And Maharaj was dancing with his dinda.
I was not dancing, but yeah. You were making me dance. But about 20 years in India, I left
dancing
and doing kirtan, but here I am doing kirtan. So much speaking, so much is speaking. After that we went to
Birmingham.
And after that we
Leicester.
There in Indian community. Temple, Sanatana Dharma Mandir. So big gathering for 3 days. I told Srimad Bhagavatam and all other things. All that so impressed. So good preaching was there. I think you can describe, or Nodip Prabhu can describe something more. That so many. Oh, we went to Manor.
Manor, yeah.
This was the first motive to go there and to take the feet dust of Lotus Swamiji Maharaj. See, so many, come on, so many devotees with us, about 100 or all gathered there. Come on. Here is place. Come on. These devotees honored us and they. When we reached about 5, what?
Conscience.
And Mridang and Kapal and Haribo, we entered the Manor temple and we offered our Pushpanjali to the lotus feet of Swamiji. And we took darshan of Arati there, went to the room where he used to write and to take rest. And also we went to Goshala, where so many cows were there. My main object was to take the dust of the lotus feet of Swamiji. So this mission was fulfilled there. And also my mission was that the devotees who had been ignored by this kind devotees, they should again come and they should have again faith on that mission, Swamiji's mission, what we have given them. They were like dry seeds, but I saw that after giving water, any doomed creeper becomes again
enlivened.
Enlivened
again, becomes green. Yeah.
Like this. All the disciples of the senior devotees of the Swamiji were so much glad to meet me and to hear my classes in London. They came to me and to discuss something that we have heard that your mission and preaching is different from the preaching of Swamiji. You are preaching different things. So we want to question some questions.
Brinda.
has been become
the senior. The senior disciples of Swamiji privately wanted to see me and to discuss all these things. And they put me 3-4 questions. I answered them. I told them that these are false propaganda, that his line and my line are separate. In one line, we are doing so many things. He is in the disciplic order of our Rupa Sanatan, Raghunath, and also from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, up to Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada. His mission and teachings are not different from them. He was Bhakti Vedanta Swami. I am Bhakti Vedanta Narayan. Not in difference, but you are seeing it from very far away. And perhaps it is ignorance that you are seeing like this. Anyone can see difference between Rupa Goswami and Jiva Goswami. Because Jiva Goswami has told something, but Jiva Goswami told the same thing in other words. There is difference of words, not motive. Anywhere Rupa Goswami has told that. We are the Palyadasi of Srimati Radhika. And none of them, gopis, were married to Krishna. But Jiva Goswami has told that all the gopis were married to Krishna. It seems different. But for some devotees, those who are so high rank, qualified, and those who are beginners, Jiva Goswami told for beginners that gopis were married to Krishna, and those who were graduating this love affection, for them he told that no marriage at all. Because in Srimad Bhagavat there are so many lakhs and lakhs instances, and there are so many slokas, pati sutanvaya Bhratri-brandhavan ati-bilanghate anta-atyutagata. It has told that gopis living behind their husbands and all others, the reign of the Krishna. If they have not married to other places, and if they were married to Krishna, what was harm meeting? Nothing, but hidden way, they met to Krishna in the night and they began rust. There was no any other person, only gopis and Krishna. And Krishna told that you should go to your husband. Don't be here. Then how? That they were married to Krishna? You should know, in Indian culture, Vedic culture, first Upanayan is done. Upanayan means, you know,
Upanayan.
Secretary and fire jagya. And after that, marriage is done. Without this,
no
marriage cannot be done. We know all that this Upanayan is fire jagya was done in Mathura, not in Vrindavan. So how it was that Krishna was married there? So marriage was not there. So Rupa Goswami Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, all are of this idea. It is called Parakiya Bhava. No? Because in marriage, in Indian culture, Vedic culture, wife becomes like a dasi, maid servant. And she is controlled by her husband. The husband has power that you can get up from my home. And she cannot tell anything if he is chaste lady. Like Dwarka, Krishna threatened once Satyabhama that go at once out from my palace. He told once. Because they were married. Ramchandra told Sita twice that I cannot take you with me. You can go anywhere where you want. First he told him in Lanka, and second, when he came, returned from Ajodhya, and after 11,000 years after that, in his last pastime, he told Sita that you can go anywhere you like. She went to the cottage of Valmiki, you know, all these things. Sita has nothing to tell. She was telling that Ram has not left Sita, but a king has left her, his wife, for anything. And this was the fact. Ram has never left Sita. But anyhow, so if all the gopis are married to Krishna, no? Why hiding all these things? In Vrindavan? And Krishna told that you should go to your husband, you should not come to me. If the husband is blind, he is so poor, penniless person, he is wicked or anything, he has leprosy, you should go and serve them. But Krishna was defeated by gopis. He told that you are Parampati and you are our guru. So guru must be worshipped first, then animals. We will worship our husband, but first you are guru, giving so many beautiful teachings. So we will worship first you, and if you are not acting, then you are doing against Vedic riti, Vedic culture. Krishna began to smile, and then dance was gone, rash itself. So if there was marriage there in Vrindavan, then they were equal to Satyabhama, Rukmini and all 6,108
queens.
No difference at all. So why Radhika and gopis are superior than? But Jiva Goswami was initiated by Srila Rupa Goswami and he was disciple of Rupa Goswami. Then why he told? Who told for juniors and those who are not so qualified. But he is also true. By the angles of vision, of Siddhant, he is right. And Rupa Goswami, angle of vision of praying, both are right. As a Siddhant, Jiva Goswami is telling us the same thing, and Rupa Goswami same thing. Jiva Goswami has given one proof that in childhood when Krishna is a boy of 1 year or 2 years. Nanda Baba took him and went to grazing in Bhandirvan, very dense forest, very dense forest. There is, the sky was full of clouds and it is about to heavy rain. And it was winter season. Nanda Baba thought, what to do? Heavy rain is coming and wind is coming also. In the meantime, a beautiful, very beautiful girl came. And she was the daughter of Rishabhanu Maharaj, Srimati Radhika. Very little girl. And he did like so, and Krishna came out from the hands of Nanda Baba to the hands of Srimati Radhika. And at once taking Krishna, he vanished and went in the dense forest. Very, very big banyan tree was there, and it is called Bhandirvat. It was within 2-3 miles. It was. And there, at once Brahma came with 4 Vedas in 4 hands and began to recite mantras. And all the Sakhi came. And Krishna became Kishore, the age about 14, and Srimati Radhika as 13. And they gave each other. And this is a kind of marriage. So marriage was done. But Mali Gopis and Srimati Radhika and Krishna knew. Nanda Baba or anyone could not know. But marriage was done. Ji Goswami is telling that, oh, marriage was done. It is right. And one thing more. When Brahma has stolen all the cow herd boys and the calves and kept it in the deep cave. Then Krishna for 1 year became all the cow herds and calves, even their cloth, even their bansi, even their everything, kambal, you know?
Blanket.
Everything he became. No one cannot. No one knew this fact. They thought that their children, their cubs, are there. In 1 year, the priest of Jadav, Gargachar, declared that this is a very pious year. In this year, any father and mother, they can give marriage to daughters to any gop, and they will be very good result. It will be mangalam.
Auspicious.
The girls will never be widow. And they will be so wealthy. And lakhs cow will be there. At that time no wealth, but cows were wealth. So go dhan, it has been told. So all the gopis were married to Krishna. But Krishna was in other shape, in the shape of all cowherds boy. So marriage was done also there. But no one knew that Krishna was all the gopis and all the gopis were married to Krishna. But in fact it was done. Also we should know that who were gopis? Who is Srimati Radhika? In Brahma Gayatri, Bhargaha Devasya, Devasya Krishnasya Bhargaha, the potency of Krishna, the power of Krishna, The energy of Krishna is Srimati Radhika. She cannot be differentiated. Like iron and its fire and its heat, sun and sun's hot are rays. They cannot be separate. They are one. So they cannot be separated. We cannot separate fire and its energy, heat. We cannot separate, you know, mrigamada, kasturi,
musk,
you know, it comes from the
navel
of
deer.
The fragrance and that
musk.
They cannot be decided. But anyhow, they can be done. How they can be done? Take a fire here, fire in body. Go some distance from fire. Heat is coming up to there. They are filling heat there. But fire is there. If heat is not different to fire, how heat goes there? Some difference. But without fire, it cannot be. So, different and non-different, both at a time. So, Srimati Radhika and Krishna, different and non-different. Actually, they are not different, but for Vilas. Vilas, you know?
Pastimes,
they become. So, all the gopis are kaya vyuha, manifestations of Srimati Radhika. They are not like us, soul. They are not soul. This is not. Yashoda Maiya, Nanda Baba, Siddham Subal, all the gopis are not soul but the energy of Krishna. And one part that energy which is the subject, pramukha,
supreme,
principle
is Radhika. All are manifested in all gopis. Why? For Vilas. If there is a kripa but no lips, no fruits, no manjari, then no
beauty.
So all the gopis are from Radhika, being themselves a Radhika. There is no difference between lips and free. No difference. But some difference. This is called achinta bheda bhedvad. Our mind and body, they are separate from soul. Not achinta bheda bhedvad. But Krishna and our soul are different and non-different at all. So it has been told regarding Shakti and Shaktiman. Krishna is Shaktiman and Srimati Radhika and all the gopis are Shakti. So there is difference and non-difference. So what is the use of marriage there if they are different? Potency, energy of Krishna? No. So, Rupa Goswami has told, Jiva Goswami has told, by Siddhanta they are of Krishna and they will be of Krishna. No use of marriage. And if to show marriage has done no harm. So, Jiva Goswami and Rupa Goswami in the same category, in same line. no difference of opinion, but it seems that there is difference of opinion. To whom it seems? Those who are not qualified for them. But those who are qualified, no difference. In the same way, he came first and he used to cut the jungle and told that, oh, come on with us and have a, what?
Axe.
And cut all jungles. And after, when the jungle is clear, anyone is telling that we should give a seed there. And again he told that, I give some water and the sprouts come. He tells, oh, again you should give water. And then lips are coming, manjaris are coming, fruits are coming, and we are testing that fruit. In the same line, all these things. But if you tell that he gives said, but at that time no lips, it is different, then lips are coming. No difference at all. So, or all the acharyas in our disciplic order have told the same thing. Swamiji has come to Western country for this. They also told that Jeev has come from Golok Vrindavan. I told that I will not answer this question. I want to read some
quotations
from Swamiji, and you should read and then you should realize what is true. I read there about 14-15 quotings of Swamiji. They told that, oh, we have not read this. never read this. And he has said like so. So no difference at all. So for beginners, it can be told that Jeev has come from here. No way to make them understand, because they are learning A, B, C, D. But when will go in matric and after that in graduate classes, they will know these things. Jadgatva na nivartante taddham parma. Anyone goes there, never returns. In Gita, in Srimad Bhagavat, 100 times it has been told. I told him to read all these things from the books of Swamiji. And he read, and all that was. Oh yeah, all these things are here. Swamiji, yes, all these things are there. What I tell, all the things are in Swamiji books. I don't tell anything beyond what he has told. Anything, new, nothing. He had no time at that time. Only he came here and in only 15 or 14 years, he preached all the world. And after he went, at once, so everything he cannot tell. But he has written in his all books, all everything. Those who are so intelligent and those who are read in the guidance of any good Vaishnava, realized Vaishnava, sincere Vaishnava, that is so, oh, close your
open your eyes.
Open your eyes and see. Here it is. They told, oh, they are in false propaganda. Here it is. Now you are seeing that you are telling all these facts true. You are not in other land. And they began to pursue me. Where I went, they all went in a group. And Gaur Premanande. If you want to hear something, that what I answered them, You have that here?
It's in the other room.
If you want to hear. He has given the page number. He has given the slope where he has told in purple. But we are not so much. At home, that we can see. In Gita, everything is there. But we are Gita reading daily. But I know that you don't know the deep meaning. Very deep meaning. He has written his purpose, but purpose meaning is also so deep that key is in the hands of very
qualified
devotees. Each sloka of Srimad Bhagavata and Gita has 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10 meanings. Deeper.
Most.
And when we realize this, we jump, our hearts begin to jump. Oh, how beautifully Vyasadeva has written in this thing. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, what has not told in Srimad Bhagavatam and Gita? In Chaitanya Charitamrita, everything is written openly. And he has told, at first when I was reading Chaitanya Charitamrita, I was so much fear. I am fearing at that time. It should not be
disclosed.
But I knew that. I know that. There are so many kinds of animals. So many kinds of animals. You know camel?
Yes.
What they take?
Thorns.
They will not take mango. You know crow?
Yes.
Crow sits on the branches of any neem tree. Neem is so much
bitter.
But pila,
yellowish,
that fruit. And crow especially will sit there. And behind that tree there is a mango tree. And very delicious and sweet fruit of mango is there. So fragrant and so sweet. But yet he will not go there. He will sit on the neem tree and very good. I have never tasted that like that. But the cuckoo bird and parrots will never sit on neem tree. From far away they will smell the sweet smell of mango and they will go and sit on the mango branches and they will give their mouth
beach.
That mango and they will taste so much. So in this world there are persons like also animal, dharma nehina pashubhir samana. Those who have not realized soul, they don't know what is body, what is soul, they think that this soul is this body. No difference. And when anyone is dead, everything goes. They have no realization of Atma. They don't know. They were liquid for these sense gratifications. Like Hitler, Mussolini, Napoleon Bonaparte, you know. In our countries, Kansa, Jarasandha, Ravana, Hiranyakashipu, all were this kind. At first, there were only two brothers, Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyaksha. And Ravana,
Kumbhakarna,
two only brothers. Now we see that only devotee are, and all others like Hiranyakashipu, Ravana, Kansa, all. You know that in England there is a very problem for beefs,
cow.
They are created themselves. and now they are struggling. So we make so much. Because we know that this body is myself. And we have come only for sense gratification. But really we have come to realize soul, what is soul, what is body, why we are coming, from where we are coming, where to go beyond. We are struggling for whole life to collect all the things by which we will be so happy. But we see that after death, this one hair, anything of this world, they cannot take. Where to take and where to go, they don't know. All is in dark. Why they are doing so much things for happiness? That we see it. All is turning in unhappiness. Why? We know that any person of America, motor car wala,
Alfred Ford.
So much wealthy, so much wealthy.
Motor car wala.
And again, more he wants. More is coming. I heard that he was so fat, so fat. He could not
go in his car.
He was a big motor rushy. He has to ride on his car, then crane was used. When he used to tools, then like this, water is given. And he could not take one half glass of koi rush
juice
of orange. And doctors used to come, always having. What is this? Is it happiness? Is it the result of wealth? We'll have to be old. Have to go. We are bound to be old.
Samuel.
No? Whole, in this whole world, all scientists will come and they will manage that, and all doctors, everyone will come, whole wealth. But when we are dying, they cannot shake us, stop us from dying. We'll have to die. We should think that after death, what we will take there. I told you one story of
thread and needle.
We cannot take a thread and needle. All scientists and doctors will come and they will try that over this hair should not be white. But they will be white. Our eyes are bound to it. So much weak, and one day so many persons will come and they will take our body and they will take us to burial ground and they will be put there. We know, but yet we are struggling, doing so what?
Sinful.
Duplicity and
hypocrisy
for all this. So we should know all these things and try to be sincere and pray God. And God of God is Krishna, Supreme Personality of
God.
He is ocean of rush, He is powerful, He can do anything. So we should try to take His shelter, Lord's feet shelter, and try to surrender ourselves in the Lord's feet of that God. then we may be happy. And the chain of birth and death will be stopped there, otherwise not. You will have to go, you will have to become cows also. And the persons which are taking the place and all these things, they will have to be cow, and cows will come in the shape of men and they will take them. Everything comes, reaction, must be reaction. So we should try to avoid all these bad things and try to take shelter in the lotus feet of Krishna. Sarva dharmana parityajya What is the difference in my this line of preaching and Swamiji line? I think that Swamiji has told everything. But anyone should have eyes to see all these things. The same thing Siddhar Maharaj was a very great philosopher. Very great philosopher. Or Guru Maharaj was very good, great philosopher. Bona fide philosopher. And realized so. But we could not realize them who are. Swami was like this. We could not realize him. We think that we can satisfy him, we can please him by outer external activities. But he has not come for these things. He has come to take us in line of bhakti yoga. So I told them, and I showed them so many
quotations
of Swamiji, and there was change totally. They told that, oh, these are false propaganda about him. And they again came with me several places and heard me there. And they served me so much and helped me. Again, leaving them, I have come to Holland, but as I took all you all in my pocket, and always I remember to see you, I remember you, I am remembering, and feeling separation from them also. Some of them, many of them have told that we that you are telling everything which are written in his books, but we are not realizing. We want to realize. When we hear your lectures and then we read the books, oh, meaning becomes apparent and apparent. You know, Jadurani?
Yes.
I call her Shyamrani. Jadurani. Hearing me, he began to wait, and she told what I told. When I hear your lectures and then I read the Swamiji explanation and purport, then I clearly see that what you are telling, all are in the books of Swami. So there are two kinds of Bhagavatam. One Grantha Bhagavat, book Bhagavat, and other is Bhakta Bhagavat. The key of the Grantha Bhagavat, book Bhagavat, is in the hands of
Bhakta
Bhagavat. That will unlock and then we can have some. I pray to Swamiji and pray to Krishna, Srimati Nanda, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu, they should bestow their causeless mercy to you, that you should enter in a real bhakti realm. and bhakti. So today I want to take rest, but because I have come, so some kirtan should be done. And you can tell something? No, no. Preaching? One thing also, I there received a copy of his magazine, very beautiful. In that, my preaching was also given. The photos of Siddhar Maharaj, Puri Maharaj.
Swami Maharaj.
Swami Maharaj. Myself. And he has written so marvelous. You should read and see. I became so happy to read his writings. I think that in future he will also help the devotees in the same manner. And he had determined to publish a magazine, Ray of Harmonist. You know Harmonist? It was established by Srila Prabhupada Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. I want that some writings of Swamiji, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, sometimes little Jiva Goswami, Rupa Goswami, our acharyas in disruptive orders, Siddhar Maharaj, Swamiji, also be given in that. And thus we should try to combine all the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's family. We are all in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu family, Krishna family. Those who take one time, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Jai Sachinandan Gaur Hari Ki. They should all be treated as the family of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We should regard and honor them. Then our bhakti will be.
Can I ask a little question?
What?
There is Bhakti Maharaj is visiting Holland now. Eh? Bhakti Maharaj is visiting Holland. So we didn't go to his lecture. I'm wondering now, because some people may think I'm an offender. If I'm making an offense by not visiting his lectures.
You should tolerate. Don't be furious. Let them say. We should honor devotees. Try to follow just bhakti yoga. Like the father of Prahlad Maharaj told notorious boy, you are not following my orders. You should follow my orders and don't tell Hari Hari. Krishna Govindi, you should not tell. If you are not doing, you are naked. So, you are Vaishnava, you should try to honor them all. For anything they are telling like so, but one day they will realize. So, you should not tell. I have determined that I should not tell any word, a single word, against ISKCON or ISKCON devotees or Swamiji. Nothing. If anyone telling, ignorance. And that could be
corrected.
So we should not tell anything. Because myself is ISKCON, you are all ISKCON. ISKCON means Krishna consciousness. I told there that Narada was in ISKCON. I told that Prahlad Maharaj is very bona fide ISKCON member. I told that Hanuman was so bona fide ISKCON member. Rupa Goswami was also ISKCON devotee. Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta was also ISKCON, Krishna consciousness. So nothing to do with this time.
Thank you. You were just saying that all the Gopis are a structure of life.
गोपियां जब श्रीमती जी का अंश है तो जीव तो उनके अंश नहीं है, फिर वो वृंदावन में कैसे चले जाएंगे और इस मधुर रस को प्राप्त कर पाएंगे?
बिकॉज यू शुड सी बाय द एक्सपेंस ऑफ क्रीपर, क्रीपर लाइंग डाउन ऑन अर्थ, इफ देयर इज अ ट्री और ए बंबू और एनीथिंग टू कैच then the creeper will go up, otherwise not. So if the jivas, conditioned souls, are souls, taking the help of lotus feet of Krishna, devotees like Lalita, Vishakha, Chitra, Subal, Sridham, Nanda, Yashoda, they will take the shelter of the feet and from there they will go there.
So there is hope. If we develop it, we can go into
Madhurya
with Krishna.
Yes, certainly we will go. If we have come in the guidance of any bona fide Rashik Vaishnava in the line of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and we, by hearing the books of Swamiji's, Rupa Goswami, Sanatana, Chaitanya Chaitanya, Srimad Bhagavatam, we have a very strong desire or greed to have that thing. Then, practicing like that, Raganuga Bhakti, that is called, we can go there. Otherwise, no. Without following and going, taking shade of the Gopis' lotus feet, we can go. If you are taking this shade of
support
of Gopis' lotus feet, Brajavasis, then go.
But at the end, you will become a Gopi
after. Yeah?
Can you say again?
You will also become Gopi.
At the end of the line, you can become a Gopi as well.
Yes, we can be. Like, you can understand that. I think that you have heard Bharat Maharaj, the past times of Bharat Maharaj, was a very big king. When he came to the age of 50,000 years, at that time he was young. And at that time he left his family, kingdom and everything and became a saint. And he went to the forest for austerity or for
meditating.
When he was doing, and he came at the stage of bhav. Bhav means you'll have to know all these things. Without knowing, you cannot enter. Shraddha, nishtha, ruchi, Ashakti, Bhav, and after that. He was in eighth Bhav. Prem was to come. But at the same time, he saw a deer who was falling in the water and he was dying. He at once came and
rescued
him. Left and get milk and support it. When he became some more young, he was treated like his son, adopted son, always remembering that. He left everything for that deer. When he used to
meditate,
at once the deer comes in his lap. And he used to like do like this. Don't have affection to me. Kiss me and all this. He left his bhajan and sadhan. And one day his death came and that deer went away, ran away with his group. Any group of deers came and they were running and he also joined them and At the same time, his death also came up, that Bharat and Vajram. Where? And when he was doing this, at once he died. At that time he remembered that deer, so he became in next time deer. So anyone remembering anyone, if he will remember his wife or any beloved lady, he will become. So if anyone remember Krishna and his associates, why he will not be like them? So he will be like Gopis. If you are remembering Gopis, that we should suck by Gopis, you will also be there. That is called Ashtakaliya Leela. Ashtakaliya Leela means to meditate 24 hours. What he did from his birth to last. So if you are chanting, remembering Krishna in the same way, mind never goes here and there, then he will be surely that. There are so many histories and pastimes in Srimad Bhagavatam. A person was, there was a male, and he has so much affection for his wife, and at the time of death he remembers her and he became female. So many things. So we should try to remember Krishna always. And if we be matured, our remembrance will be in shape and being conserved Krishna.
Mera ek prashna hai, Golok Vrindavan mein hai, wahan parakiya bhav hote hain?
Wahan par parakiya bhav nahi hoga, to is shadow mein nahi aayega. If there is grazing a cow, the shadow of cow will be like shadow, not like a man. So this is perverted
reflection.
Reflections of that world. So everything, Krishna past tense, what was in Prakat Leela, is there in root, in man, in Guru Vrindavan. If it was not there, any in shadow, how it can come in this world?
Kaun Premanande
Hari Hari Bo
Shri Krishna Hari Hari.